We'll call the regular meeting of council to order at 7:06. This is for March 27th. We have regrets from Deputy Mayor Valentino. We have an agenda before us. Any changes to the agenda, Mr. Subtelli?
No, there's not.
Thank you. We need a motion to approve the agenda as presented. Councillor Ellis, Councillor Wong. All those in favor? Carried. Thank you. We'll now move into general inquiries. General inquiries, any questions from the general public? We have a 10-minute time frame. Please come forward. State your name and ask your question. Second time. Welcome. Just please state your name and ask your question.
John Bailey, Santa Ana Lease. I was going through the municipal law enforcement stuff there, and I haven't seen where you have anything here facing traffic on this paper. I haven't seen anything regarding to say facing traffic when a vehicle parked facing traffic. I'm talking about the enforcement. Yeah.
So fees and fines, we have parking bylaw, and I believe, I'll go to Mr. Cepitelli for assistance. I believe that if you're referring to a vehicle parked on the wrong side of the street,
yeah,
facing the wrong way,
yeah,
of the flow of traffic,
yeah,
that's a ticketable offense. That is the case. Is that your question?
Yes.
Yes, that is a ticketable offense.
Yes, so it wouldn't be in this?
Not specifically, but it would be under the bylaw, the parking bylaw. Mr. Subtelli?
I mean, obviously, that bylaw references the fees and fines schedule. Under the fees and fines schedules, there's a number of parking infractions that are identified in the fees and fines schedule. Those are what this bylaw refers to.
Other questions?
Yeah, my second question.
Yep.
I have been coming to the meeting here for a long time now, and I see the changes of the arena to where it regarding to volley. And I've never seen, I don't recall where it comes up in the reading where you have reading on it to the public that it's going to. Yes.
The TRCC, Thompson Regional Community Center, to the VRCC, Valet. I'll go to Mr. Subtelli in a moment, but previous to the, as part of the construction of that facility, Valet made a contribution, was the largest contribution from a corporation to the building of that facility. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think it was $3 million. With that contribution, there were certain obligations in regards to corporate sponsorship, or not corporate obligations for recognition for that contribution. And I'll go to Mr. Cepitelli with.
See, is this would have been dealt with at council. I would have to go back to get the specific time frame that it was dealt with at council.
Yeah, and how long it's going to be for?
It's going to be in Valley, namely Arena. How long it's going to be?
Off the top of my head, I believe it's a 5-year renewable term. Yeah, so if every 5 years, either party has the right to renew or not renew.
And my last question is, I would like you, Mr. Mayor, if you could, the definition of conflict of interest. Could you explain the definition of conflict of interest, please?
In regards to the definition, it's pretty straightforward in the Conflict of Interest Act and in the Municipal Act. In the instance of that, I've made my position clear, and I'll leave it at that.
Okay, all right.
Any other questions or comments? Second time, third and final. Thank you. We're going into presentations. We have Spirit Way Inc. In our presence, and they are going to come and speak in regards to an opportunity. And I see Volker and Marion out there. I'm not sure who else is coming up, but please come forward to the table. Thank you. We'll go through some, ask you to introduce your delegation. And secondly, I know we have a lot of paperwork in front of us, but I would ask that we could stick to the 10-minute presentation for, would allow us for question and answer in regards to that.
Okay, very good. Thank you very much. First of all, I'd like to thank Mayor and Council for allowing us to present today. With us here is quite a contingent, as you can see. I'll make some introductions, but in the back too, there's one, Nick G. Virgilio is a board member for Spirit Way. Duncan Regiers is a board member for Spirit Way. Linda Marcus as well. Am I missing anybody?
Hotel owners?
Hmm?
Hotel friends?
Yeah, I'm going to do this one right now. So now we have our partners too. We have a number of people here. Rob Roberts from Mystery Lake Hotel. We have Raj Tethi, who's the president-elect for the Chamber of Commerce. We have Volker Beckman, our project coordinator for Spirit Way. Marion Moorberg is our president for Spirit Way. I'm representing Spirit Way tonight as the treasurer. And this is Susan Harrison from the Meridian Hotel. So again, thank you very much for allowing us to speak today. We have, as everybody is well aware right now, that the we're in our bicentennial year for Canada, and Canada 150 was quite popular with a bunch of grants and things of that nature, but we've also delved into that world too as well. And tonight we're going to present to you some projects that we have upcoming for 2017, and I think you'll find it quite informative. We also, our theme is celebrating Canada's wildlife and wilderness. And you'll see that theme throughout. So for 2017, first of all, I'd like to speak on the United Kingdom campaign. For the past 18 months or so, we've been in talks and negotiations and things of that nature to find out. And we came across a group that actually looked us up on our Spirit Way site, saying that they were actually going to, they're quite impressed with our wolves and our walkway. So they were coming up to their own idea that they were going to also have their own fiberglass wolves they want to use as a fundraiser. And overseas, they're going to get celebrities to paint them and things of that nature. So what really started out as just an innocent conversation blossomed into something that was more, we thought would be more meaningful on an international scale. So, according to Travel Manitoba, of course, Canada will be the number one country everybody will be looking at to travel in 2017 because of our bicentennial. And according to, of course, to Travel Manitoba again, one of their top market segments for Manitoba travel, into Manitoba, sorry, is from Britain. So we thought this would be a good fit for everything. Then, of course, we found Wolverhampton, which was one of our partners. So we've been invited to go to Wolverhampton in England to participate in their tourism initiative for their city. And the idea behind that is to attract continental Europeans to their city to view the artwork that they're going to present and things of that nature. And we're being invited from May to September 2017. Participate. We will, while we're there, we've been offered to paint two of their 30 fiberglass statues. And we're going to use our theme, which is celebrating Canada's wildlife and wilderness, to do so. We've also commissioned at this point Jason Lucas to accompany us over there to paint the statues for us. So they'll be on display. The whole, right from the start to the finish, they will be displayed with the painting going on and everything. The idea behind all this is there's a huge footfall where we're going to be in. We're actually going to be in Charing Crossing Station, which is just located in downtown London, and it gets about 153,000 people per day that walks through there. So with that kind of exposure, we have an opportunity to actually market not only Manitoba, but Thompson and Churchill as well, while we're there. So the idea, the thought behind this is that we're going to run a contest in social media, and using our Facebook page, that we'll have people that qualify for a trip for $30,000 all-paid adventure trip from London through Winnipeg, through Thompson, through Churchill, and to stay at the Nook Polar Lodge, which is a five-star resort. And we'll be, that'll be about $30,000. That's what we figured the average was. So that's, and how you enter this contest is just take a selfie at our statue, and behind us will be the video running Travel Manitoba, you know, advertising Manitoba, Churchill and that. They take a selfie, they enter it in their Facebook page, and then we select a winner. So that's quite exciting. That alone will give us a huge database of potential customers for the future. We're also going to offer another tour or two, is of less value, of course, but we're going to offer adventure tours at that time too to come there in 2018. We've also been offered by the High Commission of Canada to display their our display material, like our promotional material and things of that nature, at Canada House. So we're very very fortunate to have all these partners. And to date, I'd just like to mention a few of our partners. And they've contributed anywhere from $8,000 to $22,000 so far to our efforts here. The Travel Manitoba, Frontiers North Adventures, Churchill Wild, our Thompson Regional Airport Authority, Winnipeg Airport Authority, and Comair. So we're very happy to have them all aboard. They see the value, actual value, and having international exposure back to Manitoba, and we do too as well.
Thank you, Keith. I'll just reiterate a little tiny bit. That promotion in the UK is two fiberglass wolf statues. They're 8.5 feet tall. They're donated to Spirit Way from an organization in the UK. Under Canada's 150th birthday, we're going to be in the UK for the entire summer, from May until September, and then the statues will be auctioned off, except for one which will be shipped back to Canada. We have the opportunity to have that statue in the Charing Cross subway station, which gets a footfall of over 5 million people a month, as well as in the community of Wolverhampton for the entire summer. So all of the wolves can be taken with a selfie, and we're giving away a $30,000 trip to come to Canada. What initiated this was WestJet has now got a direct flight from Gatwick, London, through to Winnipeg, and they started that last year. So we're thinking that now people can come to our community much more readily. At this summer promotion that we're doing in the UK, we are offering the citizens to see what Canada is all about. As Keith was saying, there's a great big giant video camera, TV display in the back, showing this trip and the highlights of Manitoba. We could go into details, but we don't have time. With that, we are advertising the North, not just only Winnipeg and Churchill, but also events, new events that will be coming to Thompson this fall, and we are very excited to know that we are in partnership with MAB, which is Manitoba Aurora Borealis Enthusiasts, and we are looking at hosting an Aurora Fest, which is an international photography Aurora Borealis workshop. There's only one other one in the world, in Norway, in March. And we feel here in September, which is the second best time of the year to view northern lights, with low cloud coverage and fall colors and fabulous northern lights, plus an international lineup of keynote speakers to attract people here. We've also got another festival going on At the same time, there'll be a community workshop, a Welcome Back the Northern Lights workshop, sorry, festival for our community. And that's a 8 to 10 day workshop, or sorry, festival for citizens. Kids are newly back in school. This is their second week of being back in school, and we're going to celebrate what we have in our community through arts, theater, music, all kinds of events for our town for 1 week. We've been applied for the Canada 150 grant, which we were successful in getting. We have $48,000 and change coming to our community to support that week. We're in a partnership with Mama Wetak Center. And we also have Matt Pabrowski and his Live Wolves coming to Thompson for that week to do all kinds of workshops on nature. Wildlife and wilderness is our theme throughout the whole summer, and this is partially what we're proposing. There's other events going on, and I'm just going to pass that over to Volker right now. We're having our second Wolf and Carnivore Conference, and I'll introduce Volker.
Thanks, Marion. So you can just, I'll quickly go ahead here. This is our second International Wolf Conference. We have a number of already international speakers coming. We've had expressions of interest from Japan and Denmark as well, so we expect a good turnout for that one. That leads into a strategic plan, which is currently underway with Belly Research on developing a global wolf center of excellence, which will be an economic development program that will be launched at the conference with input from professionals in their career field to help us determine the 3 to 5 year direction we will go. So all these things together, there's another sheet I think that's included in here that has references to economic development benefits to Thompson. But as you noticed in the letter that we wrote to council back on, I think, February 24th that we circulated ahead of this, there was two asks in there. One was for a $20,000 contribution for the UK campaign, which is about a $95,000 cost, and a $10,000 contribution to the Wolf and Carnivore Conference. The last time Thompson Limited did this, as well as UCN, the provincial government, and so on, and of course, because there's tighter purse strings now, some of those funds have disappeared, and that's why we need the request. We're identifying all the sponsors that Keith mentioned. We have major corporate sponsors who put money on the table for this conference because it is bringing international guests in there. So certainly the sponsors will be recognized by different levels from platinum, gold, silver, and bronze, and so on. So I'll maybe ask Raj to finish this one, please.
Yeah, so the benefits to Thompson. As we all know that new provincial government has tourism as one of their focal points. So this is going to be an opportunity for tourism here in Thompson. And to develop that market, it'll create some economic development as well. And with international tourists coming into Thompson, this is going to be a good exposure for us. Our conferences, the two conferences mentioned, are event ready. We don't have to do anything extra. We are in the final stages of planning. So we are there with the conference material. Again, promoting Thompson in England, in Canada House, Charing Cross Station. For those you've been to London, it's a very, very vibrant community. And it's going to be a good opportunity. Now, I was in Gatwick last year, and we flew with WestJet. The beluga whales were in the background on one screen, and just announcing that tourism to Manitoba, I think that was through Travel Manitoba. So we have an opportunity to actually promote our community in London. Again, by hosting international conferences, we get away from that negative stereotyping, and we bring in professionals into our community. The economic development impact is significant. There is a sheet that was distributed. So we're expecting anywhere from 100 participants to 150 participants. And the impact to the community through the hotel industry, the restaurant industry, it's going to be close to about $387,000 to $621,000. Again, We encourage the city to partner with us and the key tourism players in the industry. Travel Manitoba, Churchill Wild, Frontiers North Adventure, Calm Air, TRAA, and the Winnipeg Airport Authority as well. By doing this, we will have results immediately this year, but it's going to have a very long-lasting effect. If we do this properly, we have sufficient funding, we will put a good show, and people will want to come to Thompson.
I left out one important point. What I was very excited about with this contest that we're giving away in the UK, we're asking people to send in selfies of themselves with any one of the 30 wolves across Wolverhampton or in London proper, and we're looking to get a database of people that are interested to coming to our region, and we feel that that's going to be substantial numbers, and that is only to our future, you know, to our benefit. So.
Hey, I'm Susan Harrison. I'm here representing the Meridian Hotel and the Lone Wolf Cafe. I've lived in Thompson for 55 years, so have been through many of its ups and downs. The work that Spirit Way Inc. has done and continues to do to improve Thompson is first rate. I encourage you, Mayor and Council, to work together with Spirit Way Inc. and to embrace these projects and events that are being offered to you by the many tireless volunteers and supporters of Spirit Way Inc. Just the same way as you recently stepped in to save the 2018 Manitoba Winter Games. What better year to highlight Thompson in as many ways as possible than this year of Canada's 150th birthday. As was recently stated to CBC News by Mayor Fenske when talking about hosting the Winter Games, in quote, "and the wider exposure is also a good thing. It sends notice to Manitoba that we are still here and kicking," end quote. This sentence clearly gives the message that we are open for business and to creating new businesses and ongoing development for Thompson. People from outside our city see the opportunities that Spirit Way Inc. is creating. It's time the people within our city see the value. Your contribution, whatever you decide, will speak volumes about your vision of Thompson's future.
Again, I'm Rob from the Mystery Lake Hotel, and I've been a citizen for 6 years now, and loving my time in Thompson, and I think this is a wonderful initiative to embrace. I think there's a lot of energy and just the shift in focus to something that's a little bit more cerebral, a little more intellectual, to leverage on. We're all very well aware how Churchill has established itself internationally as an ecotourism destination. We're right on the path, and it just makes all the sense in the world to try and take advantage of that. I think the amount of monies that we're talking about are relatively small for the potential that can grow from this. And I think that there's some wonderful people involved who've really invested themselves. And I think to have world-class intellectuals, academics here, and to have people with means who are traveling the world for ecotourism come to our community, it would just be a wonderful thing to do. And I think, yes, to speak to the quotation that the mayor that was cited in CBC to send the message that there's more going on here in Thompson than meets the eye. And I think that it's a wonderful thing, and I'd really love to see the city support it and the whole community get behind it, and particularly with the 150th anniversary. I'm not sure, I haven't heard a lot about other events that are planned, but I certainly think that this fits within an umbrella to celebrate our 150th anniversary.
Questions? Councillor Wong.
And then I will give a comment. Question is, when you mentioned about you guys going to display a wolf with a TV in that train station, normally how much it cost you to rent it for how many months? 5 months?
It's 50,000 euros a week. Pardon me, 50,000 English pounds a week is the cost to rent a space there. And we were able to.
You guys paid for free for
a month. It took us a year to negotiate that, and there's different things that happened for us to be able to get mm-hmm. that space for a month.
I'm glad you brought up the prize, the travel prize, because I neglected to also say that not only are we giving away a travel prize for $30,000 to the public, but we're offering packages for people to come and travel to our community, travel through our community in conjunction with Churchill as well as Thompson as a destination. So we're not just giving away a travel prize, but we're also advertising. This is how you can come and do it if you want to come and do it yourself. So there's several different packages available.
Okay. And a comment. Appreciate the work. I don't know what kind of word I should use, but excellent job. How you guys accomplish the passion, and I think if City of Thompson do not involve, is a shame, right, Mayor? Thank you.
Any other questions? Just from Colleen, did you have?
I just want to say, you guys, I know how hard everybody's working, much appreciated. And this is, you know, with all the economic gloom of talking down the line, that this is one of the positive spins that'll play on for a long time.
Penny, Councilor Byer, sorry.
Again, not a question, but a comment. So often people say that there's nothing to do in Thompson. They pull up a whole bunch of stereotypical things. And here you've got some real good out-of-the-box thinking ideas, something fresh and different. And I think there's a whole bunch of, I'm going to call it fodder for more things to grow from, because this can only spark more ideas as people get interested and excited and participate in it. So,
Councilor Collado.
Thank you, Your Worship. I saw your presentation at the chamber, and for those people who want more information, it was an excellent presentation. It was more than an hour long, so it's really been confined this evening. But I was very impressed, and you can get more detail if you watch the rerun of the last chamber meeting. Congratulations on your good work to your team. Thank you.
Thank you. From my seat, first of all, I want to congratulate all of you and the volunteers that aren't here for all the passion and work that's been done for many, many years, putting Thompson on the map from that perspective. I just want to also advise that in regards to, I think Raj spoke to or someone spoke to the province of Manitoba and tourism, there's an additional program out there that the federal government, Western Diversification, have approved and supplied $4.6 million to the northern region through the One North program. Mr. Sepetelli can provide contact information after the meeting or tomorrow. But there, all of the things that you spoke to in regards to events, all of them check the boxes in regards to funding to increase tourism development in the Norman region, and linking, even more important, linking Churchill to Thompson. So I would really encourage you to make that application as soon as possible. It's very straightforward. Like I say, there's $4.6 million out there and looking at the first page, every box is checked in regards to what it does. So I would really encourage you to follow that up to ensure that Thompson and the surrounding region has access and it takes advantage of that for sure. Just in closing, again, thank you very much for the presentation. Look forward to upcoming reports and updates as we go through the process here.
Yep. The website will be going up within the next week in terms of online registrations for the conference and so on, so it's very important to be there. And of course, we're indicating the people who are corporate sponsors like Churchill Wilder, Frontiers North, or Feld Manitoba are putting money on the table because they see the benefit of linking with Churchill. So we want to keep those relationships established, and that's why I think another reason to show that there's broad community support to carry those business relationships on over the next year.
Okay. The website?
Yeah. ThompsonSpiritway.ca, and it'll be on the Wolf Capital World Facebook page as well. It's 1 week to go in, and all the detailed information, speakers, registration fees, and everything will be listed there, as well as the sponsors of these events.
I'm sorry, we came with a lot of information tonight. We have 10 projects that we have on the go for this fall for Thompson. And so basically our ask here today was to say that we're going over to Europe to promote Thompson for 4 months. We've got sponsorship support from, as the gentlemen were saying, Winnipeg Airport Authority, Thompson Airport, Regional Airport, Travel Manitoba. Churchill Wild has donated over $22,000. Quite substantial donations from all these, and who am I missing out? There's quite a few others. And we are here to ask the city if they would donate $20,000 towards the UK promotion. We're going to promote our city of Thompson in the UK for 4 full months. We feel that's pretty substantial. We have 2 major international conferences that we're going to host in September, which would be the Aurora Photography Workshop, and October, which is the Wolf Conference. So just that footfall alone into our town of 2 conferences of, you know, between 100 and 150 people is anywhere from like $350,000 to $600,000 of added value back into our community. So not including the other 8 projects that we're working on. So we just feel that it's a small ask in the big world of all the big fishes out there, and we think we can really make a good footprint this year for Thompson. Thank you very much.
Thank you Next up, we have the adoption of minutes. This is for the regular meeting of Council, March 13, 2017. Resolution 2017-077, moved by Councillor Ellis, seconded by Councillor Wong. Be resolved, the minutes of the regular meeting of Council held in Council Chamber, City Hall, Thompson, Manitoba, on Monday, March 13, 2017, be adopted as circulated. Call for the question. All those in favor? Carried unanimously. Thank you. Next, we're moving into committee reports. We have the Public Works and Infrastructure Committee report as a hard copy, as well as I will go to the chair of the Public Works Committee, to Councillor Smook, to present.
This is the reporting period from December 2016 to February 2017. Our committee members are myself, Colleen Smook, Councillor Ron Matichuk, Mayor Dennis Stensky, City Manager Gary Cepitelli, Public Works of Wayne Kaversky, Harkamish Gill, Neil McLean, Don Wood, Darcy Delier, J.R. Beavis, Dave Erickson, and Dan DeCorby has been missed on the list, but he's also one of our members on Public Works. Our resource person is Lindsay Anderson. The meetings of the Public Work and Infrastructure are on the first Thursday of every month, and they're held in the Mary Fenske Room at the VRCC for anybody that can attend. Our operational highlights from this period: we have daily safe operations discussions. We had 14 burials in 2016, and we've had 3 currently in 2017. Our mechanical department did 425 repairs in 2016, and we're up to 78 already for 2017. The snow dump site has been active with contractors and city staff. Snow removal began the first week of October and is still ongoing. And do we know it's ongoing this year? Sanding operations are working Monday to Saturday. Spring operations, pothole season is upon us, we've noticed. Please call Public Works 677-7970 when you're experiencing potholes, and they will look after you. The water utility operational highlights. The storm mains year to date, last year was 10, and this year January, or was it the whole year of 2016, did we have 10 storm mains? Anyway, we will go with last year we had 10 storm mains, 33 water main repairs, and from January to March 20th we've had 9. Service breaks, last year we had 18, this year we've had 4. Last year we had 5 hydrant repairs and 2 custom service repairs. There'll be a few more hydrant repairs this year as a result of the heavy snowfalls and damage to the hydrants. Sanitary mains, last year we had 3, to this date in March 20th we've had 1, and sanitary services, last year we had 5. Infrastructure report from December to February. Wastewater treatment plant design is complete and pre-qualifier tender was issued. 6 general contractors were selected. Multi-smart panels were added into the project to be installed at lift stations. Water main renewal. Request for proposal was issued for choosing the engineer. AECOM was selected for design of the project. Issues of sewer and land drainage system being in close proximity to water main was identified, which will cause the city clay tile, will cause the clay tile pipe, which is the type of pipe for sewer and land drainage systems, to be damaged during the installation at Deerwood subdivision. To avoid this, it was decided to add sewer renewal into the scope of work. Our project is awaiting approval from the province and the federal for adding to this scope. Road renewal, design for the multi-use pathway, Princeton, and replacement of sidewalks from Thompson Drive north along Mystery Lake Road was done, and project was tendered out. Tenders were issued for replacing the air conditioning unit at the library, repairing the air conditioning unit at council chambers, installing HRV unit at engineering building in the public works yard, installing a shower room at the engineer building in the public works yard. And that's the report for today. Thank you, folks.
Council, any questions of the report? We'll receive for information. Thank you. Next, we are going into correspondence. We have a letter from Marriott Millaire and Huber Messman, co-chairs of, and Jeff Natchik, president and CEO of the 2017 Canada Summer Games, in regards to the Manitoba Hydro Torch Relay stop in Thompson. This letter is to myself and Casper in regards to the the Canada Games. Dear sirs, the 2017 Canada Summer Games and our official co-hosts, the First Nations communities of Treaty 1 and Treaty 3 and the Métis Nation, represented by the Manitoba Métis Federation, are thrilled to inform you of an exciting event coming to your community this summer. The Manitoba Hydro Torch Relay will stop in Thompson on July 6, 2017, as part of the lead-up to the opening ceremonies of the 2017 Canada Summer Games in Winnipeg, July 28, 2017. Canada Games are an inclusive nation-building experience held every 2 years, alternating between summer and winter, and are a key event in the development of Canada's young athletes. Canada Games athletes are the country's next generation of national, international, and Olympic champions. The Manitoba Hydro Torch Relay is designed to carry the excitement of the Games to different locations around Manitoba. The torch will follow a unique journey, starting with the official lighting ceremony in Ottawa on June 6, 2017, and then travel to 11 communities around the province, as well as to Kenora, Ontario. As a sponsor of the Torch Relay, Manitoba Hydro is working closely with the 2017 Canada Games staff to coordinate a relay route, choosing communities community torchbearers and a host city celebration at your Manitoba Hydro office. A representative from Manitoba Hydro and or the Canada Games will work with the City of Thompson to complete any necessary permits or requirements needed to carry out the event within city limits. We hope you're as excited as we are to take part in the Manitoba Hydro Torch Relay, and wish to thank you for your cooperation and support in making this a worthwhile and memorable experience for the Thompson residents and all Manitobans. If you have any questions or concerns related to this event, please reach out to Catherine Chernick, Torch Relay Coordinator for the 2017 Canada Summer Games, and she has her contact information there. And this is signed by Marriott Millaire, Hubert Maceman, co-chairs of the 2017 Canada Summer Games, and Jeff Natchik, President and CAO of 2017 Canada Summer Games. Council, any questions? Administration, anything to add? So we'll forward this to the Recreation Committee for coordination with the Canada Games group for July the 6th. Thank you. Next, we have a letter from Onakanu Christian Sinclair and Chuck Davidson, co-chairs of the Look North Task Force, in regards to an invitation to participate in an economic summit in Thompson. This is to Mayor and Council. We cordially invite two representatives from your community to participate in an economic summit hosted by the province's Look North Task Force. We are working with Manitoba government stakeholders, communities, and businesses to develop the Look North Partnership Strategy designed to lead to business growth and job creation across northern Manitoba. We hope you will join us and share your ideas and priorities. Led by Indigenous Mayor leader Carl Wixon of Araya Pathfinders, your economic summit will be held Tuesday, April 4th to Wednesday, April 5th, 2017 at the Juniper Center in Thompson, beginning at 2 p.m. on Tuesday and ending at noon on Wednesday. Carl brings vast experience to helping lead significant and successful economic development initiatives within and across Indigenous communities in his home country. Unlike any other seminar or session you may have attended in the past, the Economic Summit will be dealt different in that it will first and foremost work to create a safe environment for participants to share their ideas and varying points of view with the hope that this will help instill a sense of trust and openness. It will also be an all-out hands-on workshop, so come prepared to be an active participant right from the start. During the summit, participants will be asked to identify, capture, and prioritize all ideas so that they can be harnessed and harvested as they move through from concept to reality as part of the overall strategy to grow the northern economy. It will be a great day. It's important to note that while the Look North Task Force is hosting the summit, our primary role is to serve as listeners. That's because this is your summit, about your ideas, your communities, and your hopes for a more prosperous northern Manitoba. As part of this listening process, you will be joined at the summit by other solution-generating participants from business, industry, community, and from amongst our youth across the north. And I believe it says RSVP by March 23rd. I believe that was done, Mr. Cipitelli. Okay. And it's followed up with a message from the Minister, Honorable Cliff Cullen. Manitoba's North makes significant and important contributions to our province's economy, as well as unique cultural and geographical makeup. Long-term sustainable partnerships will build our northern economy, helping to ensure a prosperous future not only for the region but for the entire province. Our government is committed to strengthening our relationships with northern communities and their leaders. To that end, we established the Look North Task Force, led by co-chairs Anakanu Christian St. Clair and Opaskwayak Cree Nation, of the Opaskwayak Cree Nation, and Chuck Davidson, president of the CAO and CAO of the Manitoba Chamber of Commerce, with a mandate to develop a northern economic development strategy in collaboration with Manitobans. I'm pleased to invite your participation in the Economic Summit, one of a series of northern summits which will mark the next step in our government's pursuit of long-term economic development and job creation in Manitoba's north. These summits represent a unique opportunity to create meaningful partnerships and better understand the opportunities for growth and long-term development. They will bring together Indigenous and non-Indigenous businesses, communities, and industry in a collaborative form to identify solutions that will lead to the economic growth and diversification. It is our government's hope that you will accept the invitation to be part of our shared pursuit of economic growth across northern Manitoba. For more information or to submit your ideas, please visit www.looknorthmb.ca, and this is from the Honorable Cliff Cullen, Minister of Growth and Enterprise and Trade. Administration, anything to add? Council, any questions or comments? So we'll receive for information, and Thompson City of Thompson will be represented at the summit. Now we're going into resolutions. Yeah. Okay, this is a resolution to approve attendance at the Hudson Bay Regional Roundtable Conference. There's a Government of Nunavut email, a memo from the Executive Assistants. I would ask Council's indulgence. I'll read the resolution first, and then I would ask for a friendly amendment. Resolution 2017-078, moved by Councillor Ellis, second by Councillor Wong. Be resolved, the Council approved the attendance of Mayor Fenske and Councillor Smook at Hudson Bay Regional Roundtable Conference in Winnipeg on March 30th and 31st, 2017, and be it further resolved that attendance at this event be borne under the terms and conditions of Bylaw 1897-2013. For Council, I would make Council aware that I'm unable to travel to attend. So Councillor Smook is on the resolution. So we can leave it as that, as a friendly amendment in deleting my name, or we can add another councillor to attend. It's short notice, and I apologize for that, but I'll look for direction from Council. This is for Thursday and Friday in Winnipeg. Councillor Collada.
An interest to go, and I would still be interested.
Okay, so I would look for a friendly amendment to remove my name and insert Councillor Judy Collada. Councillor Beyer, you are offering that amendment.
Yep.
Need a seconder for that amendment? Councillor Foley. So as amended, I'll read it as amended, Resolution 2017-078, moved by Councillor Ellis, seconded by Councillor Wong. Be resolved, the Council approved the attendance of Councillor Judy Collada and Councillor Smook at the Hudson Bay Regional Roundtable Conference in Winnipeg on March 30th and 31st, 2017, and be it further resolved that attendance at this event be borne under the terms and conditions of Bylaw 1897-2013. Anything to add, Administration, at this point?
I just indicate the cost of sending to members of Council is approximately $3,000.
Thank you. With that, I'll call the question. All those in favor? Carried unanimously. Thank you. Next, we have a resolution to approve the attendance at the Mayor's, Reeves, and CAO's meeting. We have the AMM letter, memo, and executive from the Executive Assistant as well. Resolution 2017-079, moved by Councillor Byer, seconded by Councillor Smook. Be resolved, the Council approved the attendance of Mayor Fenske and Gary Sepetelli, City Manager, at the Mayor's, Reeves, and CAO's meeting in Winnipeg on April 11th, 2017. Be it further resolved, the attendance at this event be borne under the terms and conditions of Bylaw 1897-2013. To administration for support. I think that
attendance at this event is approximately $1,700.
Thank you. We'll go to the mover. Councillor Byer, anything to add? Council, any questions or comments? Seeing none, call for the question. All those in favor? Carried unanimously. Thank you. Next, we have a resolution to approve the attendance at the AMM Cities Caucus meeting, and we have an AMM email. This is resolution 2017-080, moved by Councillor Byer, seconded by Councillor Smook. Be resolved, the Council approved the attendance of Mayor Fenske, Councillor Wong, and Gary Sepetelli, City Manager, at the AMM Cities Caucus meeting in Winnipeg on April 12, 2017, and be it further resolved, the attendance at this event be borne under the terms and conditions of Bylaw 1897-2013. Administration for support.
This event is held in conjunction with the Mayor's, Reeves, and CAO meeting of the same date.
Thank you. Go to the mover, Councillor Byer. Council, any questions or comments? Councillor Foley.
There was an email that was sent out for any other members of Council that were willing to participate. Was there any responses?
I'm not aware of any.
Okay.
I'd just like to note that there was response given by me
and no discussion was had since. Thank you.
Question. All those in favor? Oh, sorry, Councillor Collado, did you have a question?
Yes, I did. I understand that everything except the registration is paid for Councillor Wong because he's a member, he's our rep for AMM, so it would just be the cost of registration for Councillor Wong?
I believe so. No, I believe everything's...
Not for this resolution.
No.
Then
any other discussion? Call for the question. All in favor? Opposed? It's carried. Next, we have a resolution to approve attendance at the Municipal Officials Seminar and the MTCML. Resolution 2017-081, moved by Councillor Byer, seconded by Councillor Ellis. Be it resolved, the Council approved Councillor Wong's attendance at the Municipal Officials Seminar and the MTCML Trade Show in Winnipeg on April 12th and 13th, 2017. Be it further resolved that the attendance at this event be borne under the terms and conditions of Bylaw 1897-2013. Administration for support.
Just to indicate, as Councillor Collada had indicated, that since Councillor Wong is the Northern District Director, his cost to attend this event is borne by the Association of Manitoba Municipalities, and the only cost for the City of Thompson is the actual registration at the Municipal Officials Seminar, which is $147.
Thank you. We'll go to the mover, Councillor Byer. Anything to add? Council, any questions or comments? Seeing none, call for the question. All those in favor? Carried unanimously. Thank you. Next, we have a resolution to approve the YWCA Women of Distinction Award Sapphire Sponsorship and a letter from the YWCA. This is resolution 2017-082, moved by Councillor Byer, seconded by Councillor Smook. Whereas the YWCA Women of Distinction Awards honor women who have made a significant contribution in their community, now therefore be resolved the Council approve the Sapphire sponsorship of $500 for the upcoming 2017 YWCA Women of Distinction Awards Gala on May 27th, 2017. We'll go to administration for support.
I just indicate that this is a resolution that's been brought forth to Council in the last number of years for support for sponsorship.
Thank you. We'll go to the mover. Councillor Byer.
YWCA works extremely hard to help people from Thompson and the surrounding areas, with a focus on women. And I think what's interesting is that the YWCA tries to recognize and help women at whatever level of the economy or career development they're at. This particular award event also serves as a fundraiser for them. The YWCA receives no core funding, And I think on several levels, it's an honor for us to be able to continue our support to this event.
Well, any questions or comments? Seeing none, we'll call for the question. All those in favor? Carried unanimously. Thank you. Next, we have a resolution to approve the tabulation of prices for the shower rooms at the engineering building. We have the tabulation of prices and a memo from Manager of Assets and Infrastructure. Resolution 2017-083, moved by Councillor Byer, seconded by Councillor Ellis. Be resolved, the Council approve the recommendation of purchasing agent and award the tender of the construction of the shower rooms at the engineering building to A&B Builders for their total tendered price of $23,165, all applicable taxes included, as per tender file number 10517. We'll go to administration for support. Thank you. I'll go to the mover, Councillor Byer. Anything to add?
I would just like to add that further within that memo, the explanations for going
to the bid that's not the lowest is that the lowest bid did not meet some of the requirements that we had in terms of safety insurance, etc. So,
Council, any questions or comments? Seeing none, call for the question. All those in favor? Opposed? Carried. Next, we have a resolution to approve the tabulation of prices for the professional auditing services. We have a tabulation of prices for professional auditing services. We have a memo from Chief Financial Officer. Resolution 2017-084, moved by Councillor Byer, seconded by Councillor Smook. Whereas the Finance and Administration Committee have reviewed the proposals from the professional audit services submitted by Kendall Wall and Pandya, MNP LLP, and BDO Canada LLP and Exchange Group, and whereas Finance and Administration is recommending the Council award the tender to Kendall and Pandya, now therefore be resolved the Council award the tender for professional audit services for the years ending 2016 to 2019 to Kendall and Pandya for $27,500 in 2016, for $28,000 in 2017, $28,500 for 2018, $29,000 for 2019, for a cost of $118,000 as per tender file number 10917. We'll go to administration for support.
Yeah, just to indicate that the RFP audit included the audit for the City of Thompson as well as three of our controlled entities, being the Planning District, Thompson Public Library, and the Thompson Recycle Center. The responses received, the criteria were established by the evaluation committee, which consisted of council members of the Finance and Administration Committee and the Chief Financial Officer. Based on these criteria, the highest score was given to or attained by Kendall Pandya. Kendall Pandya have completed the audit for the City of Thompson for a number of years and have proven track record, and therefore the committee is recommending to award the RFP for audit services to Kendall Pandya.
Thank you. We'll go to the mover, Councillor Byer.
The tabulation that we had, or the matrix we had, was actually quite detailed, and I'm very proud to be able to say that we're awarding this to a local supplier to continue services. But I want to point out that this wasn't awarded just because it is a local supplier. This business very clearly ranked exceptionally well within that matrix, and so they're a very deserving business as well. And of course, they've provided us with excellent service in the past, so they also have a track record with us.
Councilor Foley.
I thought I heard you say with a tabulation of 118,000, it's written here at 113.
Is if I said 118, I misspoke. Councilor Wong.
Thank you, Worship. My question is, what is a municipal act about the auditor? How many years they allowed to serve as auditor? Do they have any law, such a law? Because I'm concerned about the same auditor been doing for decades. So I'd like to see something change, or if there's a law or not. I just like to find out, please.
Don?
I mean, obviously through through the process and the establishing the policies by the city, of which we have a procurement policy, and we identify the time frame that to put forth the audit services, and given the nature of the business, the city has historically tendered it out for multiple years for the awarding of the audits to a company to undertake the audits of the city of Thompson, and it's really a lot to do with the knowledge that's required on a year by year basis of the operations of the city in order to provide the services that we require.
Thank you, Mr. Councilor Wong.
I'm not questioning about the process. I'm just questioning about, is there any law that prevent go further than a certain a limitation, basically what I'm trying to find out.
Perspective, there's nothing in the act that says that there's a defined time frame. We have procurement policies that are determine the length of a tender that goes out, whether it's a two-year tender or a four-year or five-year, whatever that agreement is. But there's nothing in the Municipal Act that states that there are time limits or that the previous tender award couldn't have the second time around, as this is the case. There's nothing in the Act that states that. Councillor Collada.
Thank you. My recollection is, and I haven't reviewed the Municipal Act on that topic recently, but my recollection is that we can't award it for, we have to limit the number of years that we can award it for without tendering it. So if it was tendered, we've met the requirements of the Municipal Act. My question is, I would assume it was the lowest tender, being it was a local firm and they were bidding against a firm from out of town.
They were the lowest
bid that we received, yes.
Thank you.
Councilor
Matthew. I have a concern that Manisha Pandya is on the Finance and Administration Committee, and I'm not sure that's appropriate.
Committee, but she's excused herself in all discussions in regards to this tender. That anything that is affecting her business, she declares and is excused from those discussions. Any other comments? Hearing that, we'll go for the vote. All those in favor? Carried unanimously. Thank you. Next, we have a resolution to approve the tabulation of prices for the, now we're into bylaws. This is the second reading of bylaw 1947-2016, cancel authorized authority bylaw. And we have the bylaw 1947-2016, and we have a memo from the Chief Financial Officer. This is resolution 2017-085, moved by Councillor Beyer, seconded by Councillor Ellis. Be resolved that bylaw 1947-2016, being a bylaw of the City of Thompson, to authorize that no borrowing authority remains outstanding, be given second reading. Lord Administration for support.
Yeah, so just
and obviously that this is a housekeeping bylaw that needs to be passed as per the requirements of the province. So really that back in 2010, a local improvement was passed for the purchase of the residential waste carts, and as a result, the local improvement was collected in the 2010 tax bill. No further borrowing was required. So, from a housekeeping perspective, is that we have to pass a bylaw to really rescind that initial local improvement, and as of the first reading given in November 2016. Then the bylaw is vetted through the province, through the municipal board, obviously, which we received back with some minor modifications to the bylaw, and really those modifications have been made, and it's now before council for second reading.
Thank you. We'll go to the mover, Councillor Beyer. Anything to add? Council, any questions or comments? Seeing none, we'll call for the question. All those in favor? Carried unanimously. Thank you. We're now at third reading of bylaw 1947-2016. It's required a recorded vote for third reading. Resolution 2017-086, moved by Councillor Beyer, seconded by Councillor Ellis. Be resolved that bylaw 1947-2016 be given third reading and that it do now pass. Administration, anything to add?
Nothing further to my comments previously.
We'll go to the mover, Councilor Byer, anything? Council, any questions? Seeing none, call for the question. All those in favor? It's carried unanimously. Voting in favor, Councilor Foley, Councilor Wong, Councilor Smook, Councilor Kalata, Councilor Byer, Councilor Matichuk, Councilor Ellis, and Mayor Fenske. We'll now go into the mayor's report covering the time frame of March 14th to March 27th. I had the pleasure of meeting with Becky Santos's grade 4 class at the Ecole Riverside School on March 14th to discuss municipal governance in relationship to federal and provincial governance as well as the various models. Very interesting questions and comments from the grade 4 class. One of the enjoyable tasks of being mayor is being able to go to the schools and talk to the kids. They are quite honest with their questions, from how much do you make to every other question that you can think of as well. So very enjoyable. Met with Paul Oker from the Northern Health Region as well on March 15th. Council members as well as administration attended the city school liaison meeting on March 21st. The weekly Thompson 2020 conference calls continued on Tuesday mornings. Various committees meetings were held, Human Resources, Finance and Admin, Recreation and Community Services, and Legislative and Intergovernmental Affairs. I have one proclamation. Whereas oncology nurses are committed to providing quality oncology care, and whereas oncology nurses have demonstrated excellence in patient care, teaching, research, administration, and education in the field of oncology nursing, whereas oncology nurses endeavor to educate the public in the prevention and treatment of cancer, now therefore be it resolved, Now, therefore, by the virtue of the authority vested in me and as the Mayor of Thompson, I hereby proclaim April 4th, 2017 as Canadian Oncology Nursing Day in the City of Thompson and urge all residents of Thompson to join in observance of and to participate in activities to recognize the special contribution oncology nurses provide to the public. This is signed by Mayor Dennis Fenske and stated at Thompson, Manitoba, this 27th day of March 2017. With that, I will go to Council to report on any activities that they attended to on behalf of the city from March 14th to 27th. Council, any activities? Quiet weeks? How about a blizzard? We all attended the blizzard. Anyway, with that, again, I want to thank the general public in Thompson and again raise accolades to all those involved in regarding surviving the blizzard of 2017. We're not done yet in the sense of there still is a lot of snow removal to do. We have heavy equipments on the street at various hours of the day and night. So I would caution drivers especially to be aware of heavy equipment. It is spring break this week, so there will be kids where they're not normally are during the school day because they're at home playing on the streets and areas. So be very cautious. There's still a lot of blind spots around. We're working on that. To remove the blind spots. And on that note, if there's a significant one that we've missed or we haven't got to yet, please call into City Hall and let us know. And regrettably, it's pothole season. I noticed a few on Thompson Drive already. So if there's a significant pothole that you are aware of, that we aren't, or we may be aware of and haven't got to it yet, but please call into Public Works or to City Hall to make us aware of those locations so that we can get on that. With that, I need a motion to adjourn. Councilor Smook, Councilor Foley, all those in favor? Carried. We stand adjourned. Thank you very much. Have a good evening.